Oke. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Very good morning all, especially to the chairman, the supervisors, my co-examiners, and all the participants, I mean the students attending this proposal defense. My first and to the student lah, Margaret. Margaret,
yes.
How long have you been doing your proposal already?
1 year.
1 year. Is it too early or you should go for PD already? This is a general question only. I would like to start it with a general question first.
I'm ready for PD because we have a strong special factor that we understand the topic that we need to do and how the way the do the study.
Okay, very good. Are you working, Margaret?
Yes, I'm working.
Okay, how long have you been working?
1 year plus.
Okay, very good. Your title, Margaret, is look like an essay. It's look like an essay to me, your title.
Okay.
In fact, we are doing research, research level proposal. So the first thing I would like to comment is your title. You need to resurrect your title, adjust your title to make it look like master thesis. For the current one is more like the karangan essay factor. Actually it should be factors, for example, not only one factor. So your title actually disturb me, meaning I'm not saying you are doing a wrong title. No, you just include some of the variables that you mentioned, for example, skill, unskill, merit, and so on, to insert in your title, make your title look like a researchable topic, academic topic. That is my first comment.
Okay.
And then, even though at this stage we don't have to prepare the abstract, because abstract is once we have data, we have, go to the field, but it is advisable to student to, to prepare the abstract lah. In your abstract, you mentioned that your focus of study is on the moderators. Is it right?
Moderator and four special factor, which is four factor. Education level.
Because your first sentence in abstract, showing like, look like you are concentrating on the moderating effect. So just be careful what actually your focus. Okay, how do you define labor participation?
I can't to understand this question.
Okay, what I mean is that how do you define labor participation in your context of study?
For my study or the definitions?
The definition that adjusts to your study, how do you define it?
Okay, so first I will define age group, because definitions from the economic labor force participation is age group is 60 to 64 years old and not include undergo study and housewife, and as well as the 65 and above age.
Okay. Thank you, Margaret. No wonder why your sampling is so general, because your sampling is as long as she is 16 to what, 40 years old?
64 years old.
From what is the youngest age? 16?
Yes.
16 to?
64.
54. No wonder your sampling is too general, because you are directly using that definition, so that every woman who falls in that category will become your respondent later on. So my comment lah, my suggestion, just to improve your your thesis that you need to define the labor participation in which level of labors actually. For example, is it among the executives? Is it among the lower level workers? Is it among the managerial and so on? Okay. So this is my comment to you, because that's why when your topic is too general, the sampling will become general. But when your topic narrow down to researchable topic, then your sampling will be specific. Because the reason is you are looking at your thesis based on the title of your thesis, so you need to refine the title. So in my opinion, if I want to define the level of participation, I will categorize the group. For example, among executives, for example, or among academicians, for example, or among private sectors at different levels and so on. So this is my suggestion lah. Our questionnaire, we have this demographic section tau. Demographic section, and among the items are education qualification, among the items are merit or unmerit. Okay, so this we can find in section A or the last section on our demographic in the questionnaire. My question is, in your research, you are not actually looking at merit, unmerit, skill or unskilled as in the demographic section, but it is the variable standing on it on its own. Okay, or so my point is this. Okay, my point is, actually, what is the problem that you want to research actually? I based on your presentation and based on your proposal that I read, I try to understand what actually the problem that causing you to do investigation in this topic. More or less what I caught, I saw seems like you indirectly saying there is unfairness occurred in the work in the employment in Malaysia. This is my first instinct lah when I read your thesis, and based on your presentation, I smell like you are saying there is unfairness toward women participation tau. There is unfairness occurrences which you should support by data. Actually, you should support by data, by statistic. Of course you show the statistic, but that statistic actually, in my opinion, not representable. So when you use example like Vietnam, example like Singapore, example like Indonesia. Okay, last week we have our dean in the forum. So in that forum, our dean is arguing with another speakers when we trying to compare between Indonesia and Malaysia. The problem is that Indonesia has a vast area, land area, and Indonesia has biggest population. They have 200 million, we only 30 million, for example. And then you compare with Singapore. Of course, there is no risk. What I'm trying to say is, Singapore is very small area, and it's very urban area compared to Malaysia, which are big areas. And not all, from at urban area, most of our areas are rural areas. So just be careful when we trying to highlight. For example, you highlight very strongly about Singapore, the women are like this and like this. But in Malaysia, so just be careful, because it bothers me. When we try to compare, we have to compare apple and apple. This is my point. We have to compare apple and apple. Just be careful with that. And also, I found that you seems to use literature review from African nation. You mentioned about Nigeria, and I found some in the literature as well, other cultures. Okay, I'm not stereotyping. Yeah? I'm not stereotyping African. No. I'm not stereotyping. But what usually students get, mistake a lot. Yeah, students like to refer to the journal that easy to get in the Google. You see, in which we supposed to get good journal, good referee journal from our library, online library, for example. Yeah, but it seems that students try to get references from Uncle Google. Uncle Google, Uncle Google, it always provide a lot of articles, and this is my finding, and most of the articles are not referred article, and it's common to find from article from Nigeria and so on. I'm not stereotyping, but be careful. Whenever you refer to this country, look at the quality of that journal, number one. And secondly, when we compare the on the labor participation, be careful with the different system of the country. System of the country. Like I said just now, we must compare apple to apple, my question just now is that, do you see unfairness toward women labor participation in Malaysia?
Why I have qualifications level, because I found out that of my company, director level, we have 9 of the departments, but only one woman is under director level, but all of them is a male lelaki. I found out it's unfair. Yeah, engineering and culinary department also a lot of the men, even women can work about this one, but the director or the manager level are not so believed to their staff or not so believed to women.
Thank you, Margaret. Now I detect your problem already. Based on your explanation, I detected your problem. Actually, kan, Margaret, it was what happened to me when I did my MBA last time. I am the product of MBA, in which I thought I am working in the administrative sectors. I'm working in UMS, so I assume that UMS picture the overall problem. Scope of the study. Please revise how to write scope of the study. Basically, when we write scope of study, we include on what actually our research is focusing on, who actually the target respondents, how are we going to do the sampling, and include some literature review showing the reason why we use such and such variable. So that is actually the phase of scope of the study. Okay, and then the significance of the study, at least we must have theoretical and practical significance lah. This is a must. Theoretical and practical significance. The rest are added value. There is a comment for significance of the study. And then definition of key terms. Usually we try to find not only one definition when we want to explain our definition for in the study. Actually, we try to include some other relevant definition, but we pick one which is really suit our research variable, for example. In your background of study, I don't know whether in background or in the problem statement,
Majlis
Penasihat Wanita Sabah. When you first mentioned that, kan, actually I'm waiting for what is their result. What is their result? Because you just mentioned to the extent that government established this Majlis Penasihat in order to study or understand the situation of women participation lah. And actually I'm looking forward to read what is the result. So basically we just not, don't mention, but we want to tell readers what's the finding, because that is where we can pick up the rest of the writing actually. Yeah, but that is very good source of information when you use Majlis Penasihat Wanita Sabah. So we can see the real situation, the practical situation, what is happening, and actually that is the government effort. Yeah. Okay, I go to the chapter 2. Basically, chapter 2 and chapter 1, Madam Roslina already mentioned, I also already mentioned, and similar like Madam Roslina, I'm surprised you don't have theory, right?
Yeah.
You don't have theory. You know what is theory? What is the role of theory?
As what I learned previously, what Nina mentioned, that is they have label theory, label force theory, and the allocate time theory.
That is theory. But my question is, why do we want to use theory?
We need to implement the theory for our study to support it.
Okay, more or less you got the meaning, but actually theory is the driver. Imagine we are driving a car and there is no driver, so the car is not moving. So this is the role of theory in research. Yeah, without theory you are not going anywhere. This theory will relate one variable from the other variable. This is the theory. So very important, in any research we must have theory. And just imagine the car without a driver, you are not going anywhere. So I read in your literature review, your second, chapter 2, yeah, about work-life balance and flexible working arrangement. You are choosing work-life balance as your IV, right? Work-life balance. Work-life balance is actually a very big word in research, work-life balance. In fact, flexible working arrangement is part of work-life balance. It is antecedent to work-life balance. What I'm trying to say is, if you are satisfied using work-life balance, then it is okay. You have the justification. In my opinion, the dimension of work-life balance, for example, antecedent, flexible working arrangement, may suit your research problem. Yeah? But don't change according to my comment. Change if you are justified, if you can justify it, yeah? Okay, so, okay. And then the way you write the format, yeah? You lose element of connecting sentences. What I mean is that you mention about childcare, you mention about agriculture, but you did not have sentences or support paragraph how these two keywords, childcare, agriculture, relate to the women labor participation. You are missing that paragraph or that sentences. Eh? You are losing your connecting sentences, Margaret. But that childcare, I understood what you are trying to say. I understood. When you mention childcare, I understood. Meaning, when you say agriculture, I understood. But to the common readers, they won't understand what are you trying to say. You don't have the connecting sentences or paragraph explaining the relationship between these two keywords with women labor participation. Yeah, Margaret? So you need to improve on that. Okay. So I think your format of writing lah. I saw you use colorful picture, colorful graphic and so on. Actually, it is not advisable to use colorful graphic. Yeah. Maintain the black and white. And then your format, for example, you are using table, but that table only appear after 2 or 3 paragraphs ahead. You got what I mean? It's supposed to be the table, the figure immediately after the related statement, yeah, in the paragraph. But you seem to put it two or three paragraphs ahead. Then you put the table because you want to play with the pages, kan? And then you did not label it. For example, figure one, table one in the sentence structures in the paragraph. Okay, so you need to improve that. I'm trying to say, your elaboration is not, it's not comprehensive. And then also you give some opinion, like what Madam Roslina noticed, the saying but no citation. This okay. is what we call opinion. The saying okay. and citation. This is what we call facts. So in academic, we want to hear the facts, not opinion. So the minute you did not cite the references, that is opinion. That is a claim. Yeah, claims need to be supported. You lack of that. And then your hypothesis, you simplified two dimensions. For example, merit, unmerit, skill, and unskilled. Just one hypothesis. Actually, when we have these two kinds of dimension in a barbell, this is where we call hypothesis A, hypothesis B, for example. But you just lump sum one hypothesis. So you need to improve that. And then, again, actually, the root of your issues is because of your title. That is the root of your issues, in which your title is not academically written. Yeah? So just improve that. I think that's all from me.